Before this tutorial, you probably copied and pasted titles, description and keywords for each stock video and for each stock content agency separately. This took a lot of your time. In this tutorial, I will show you how to automate this task by embedding metadata into stock videos using the free Exiftool program and save you a lot of time. No programming experience is required, and anyone with basic computer skills can replicate what I demonstrate in this tutorial. In our previous two videos, we went over how to use Exiftool to embed keywords and title into stock image files. I linked those tutorials in the description down below. Generally, there are three approaches to supply keywords, title and descriptions for photo and video files for stock content websites. First is to manually copy and paste metadata for each file for each stock photo platform. This approach is very inefficient and should be avoided. The second approach is to embed data directly into media files before uploading them. When you do so, stock photo platforms will recognize embedded keywords, title and description and display them in their submission system, eliminating the need for manually copying and pasting this data. There are two ways to embed your metadata. One is through Adobe Bridge or Adobe Lightroom. We made a tutorial on how to do so in Adobe Bridge and why Adobe Lightroom is unsuitable for this task. Using Adobe Bridge to embed metadata is better than the first approach, but still inefficient as it involves a lot of clicking, copying, and pasting. The other option is to embed metadata using free Exiftool program, which is the topic of this tutorial. It is highly efficient and does a lot of work automatically for you. There is also a third option, and that is to upload a metadata spreadsheet directly to stock photo websites. Each stock photo platform will recognize this spreadsheet and will display keywords and description for each uploaded file in their submission system. This method is also highly efficient and we will cover it in our next tutorial. So how do you embed metadata into video files using Exiftool? Exiftool is a popular free program that lets you read and write metadata in images, videos, and many other media format files. To use it, install Exiftool following the instructions I provided in my previous two videos. I linked in the description down below. Alternatively, you can follow the instructions on the Exiftool webpage. Next, have all your stock videos in one directory. When you try this algorithm for the first time, I recommend using a backup copy of your files just to see if things work right. While you can embed metadata into each video file separately, this is not what we are after here. Luckily, Exiftool allows its users to take metadata from a comma-separated values or CSV spreadsheet file and embed titles, descriptions, keywords, and other data into multiple video files automatically and quickly. This is a CSV spreadsheet template I created specifically to write metadata into video files using the Exiftool for various stock photography websites. This CSV format can be easily edited using any spreadsheet software such as Excel or OpenOffice. It is important to maintain the exact header with column names as shown here. I shared this template with a link in the description for macOS and Windows users separately. The first column is the source file, which must contain the exact path and name of your video file. If you are a Windows user, your path will look like this, with backslash notation, while for a macOS user, it will use slash notation instead. In my previous tutorials, I go over how to extract and paste this path for a large number of files quickly on Windows and macOS. The next three columns use the QuickTime tagging format to write title, description, and keywords. Note that keywords must be separated by comma, and each keyword can be either one word or multiple words. The next three columns will contain your title, description, and keywords, but this time using XMP format. XMP format stands for Extensible Metadata Platform, developed by Adobe. Naturally, you would ask, why in the world do I have to write the title, description, and keywords the second time in XMP format? Didn't we just do it with a QuickTime format? And the answer is, yes, you do need to write this metadata the second time, separately in XMP format. For one reason or another, different stock photography agencies recognize title, description, and keywords written in different formats. I tried all possible combinations for four major stock photo agencies and came to the conclusion that QuickTime and XMP formats will cover most bases. Here's a table that shows which metadata information Shutterstock, Adobe Stock 0.5 and Getty images accept. As you can see, Shutterstock does not recognize any of it. No matter what I tried, including other formats I didn't show here, it just wouldn't work. I will address this issue and how to deal with Shutterstock at the end of this tutorial. All stock photo agencies in this table would recognize QuickTime format for keywords. Getty Images was very particular about having titles and descriptions written in the XMP format for some reason. Coming back to the CSV template file, the last four columns denote copyright information. You can change these two columns to indicate your name and a different copyright notice if you'd like. Otherwise, you can keep the other two columns as is if you want your videos copyrighted. In principle, you can modify many other types of data fields in your video files. You can refer to the Exiftool webpage for further instructions. To write this metadata into your stock videos, execute the following command in the terminal on macOS or the command prompt app on Windows. Refer to the tutorial videos I made on writing metadata to stock photo images I linked in the description for more details what each part of this command means and how to execute it. It is important to preserve the notation here, especially for path. Okay, let's run a test. I have this folder on a Windows operating system. Next, I would copy the file path like so and paste it into the CSV file. For macOS, this path looks a bit different and uses slashes instead. I updated each metadata field in my CSV spreadsheet accordingly. Next, I open the command prompt in Windows and type the command I showed before with changes to the path as necessary. I execute this command and Exiftool lets me know that it wrote metadata successfully. Next, I upload this file into Shutterstock. And as you can see, none of the metadata was recognized. Very strange indeed. However, Adobe Stock 0.5 and Getty Images Deep Meta recognized and accepted the relevant metadata, as you can see from these screenshots. So what do you do about Shutterstock? Well, besides copying and pasting everything manually, you can use approach number 3, and that is uploading a CSV metadata file I briefly talked about. A complete tutorial about uploading CSV metadata files is coming and I will link it above and in the description. Subscribe to our channel to be notified when this tutorial comes out. Overall, I highly recommend maintaining a separate spreadsheet with all of your metadata for stock videos and photos for your own records in one place. This file may look like this and can contain columns such as file name, title, description and keywords. We personally keep our stock photography records in Google Sheets for ease of access and automatic backup. You can also keep track of your file's acceptance and rejection for each stock photo agency with separate columns too. Having such a spreadsheet will make it easy for you to embed metadata using the Exiftool or create a separate CSV spreadsheet files with metadata that you can upload and apply to your uploaded media files on stock photo platforms. In our future videos, we will share our entire workflow from start to finish and how we edit photos and videos, maintain and keep track of our stock content before and after submission. We will also talk about resubmitting your content. We came up with this workflow after carefully refining it since 2015. We hope that sharing our work will help our audience speed up and automate certain repetitive and tedious tasks and make the entire process more enjoyable. If you found this video helpful, please give it a like. Subscribe to our channel as we will have more tutorials that will help you succeed in stock photography business. We also regularly post travel guides and other tutorials that will help you grow your photography skills as well.